How's everybody? The natives, if you can hear them, they're getting restless, and I think they're ready. So glad that you are here. Can't wait to see your children sing and perform for us tonight, and then have some good brisket and fellowship with you guys. So just glad that you are here, and let me open with prayer, and we're going to get started. Pray with me. Father, in the name of Jesus, we love these kids. We know, Father, that you love them. We pray that they would come and that they would just bless us, Father, with confidence, and that they would that there would be joy in this place, Father. We thank you that you love each and every one of them. You love each and every one of us. Father, may this evening bless you as it blesses us. We pray it in Jesus' name. Amen. Enjoy the program.
The needed a Savior. People strayed away from God and couldn't follow His law.
But God still loved us, and promised to save us, so He sent Jesus.
For God so loved the world that He gave His only Son, that whoever believes in Him shall not perish but have eternal life.
Christ the Savior was born.
Our story begins with the government.
In those days, a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration when Quirinus was governor of Syria. And all went to be registered, each to his own town. Luke 2, 1 through 3.
Joseph's family came to Bethlehem.
So Joseph went there to register with Mary, who was about to have a baby.
Bethlehem was a busy place that night. There was no room in any of the hotels.
Even the Airbnb places would have been full. That's how busy it was.
Mary and Joseph might have been pretty scared with Mary pregnant and no place to stay.
But they trusted God that had a plan for them, and God's plans are always perfect.
So they found a stable where they could sleep, and they stayed there with the animals.
And at just the right time,
in God's chosen place,
she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger because there was no place for them in the inn. Luke 2:7.
Christ the Savior was born.
Wonderful news.
Life-changing news.
Everything-changing news.
So if it were you, whom would you choose to spread this good news?
Maybe someone famous.
Someone rich.
Someone important.
Someone with a lot of Facebook friends.
Not God. He chose shepherds.
God chose poor, ordinary people. The simple people who were watching their sheep in a field outside of Bethlehem.
They were minding their own business and their sheep when suddenly
an angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were filled with great fear.
And the angel told them not to be scared. He said, "I have some really good news, guys.
For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord." Luke 2:11.
Suddenly there was zillions of angels.
sending this little baby to save the world.
Shepherds must have been a bit stunned.
I mean, angels singing, God's son lying in a manger. Crazy stuff.
But the shepherds trusted God and followed the angels' directions.
When the angels went away from them into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go over to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has made known to us."
They found everything just as the angel had said.
In the least fancy place imaginable, a feeding box for animals. They found the baby Jesus, God's son, our Savior.
The shepherds knelt down and worshiped him right then and there.
Then they just couldn't keep this good news to themselves. They had to tell everyone they saw.
Christ the Savior is born.
I wonder if some people thought those shepherds were bonkers.
After all, God's people had waited so long for a Savior.
And for him to come in such a quiet, humble way, now that was unexpected.
But the Bible tells us all the people who heard the news from the shepherds were amazed. God's promise to save us was fulfilled at last.
you, but celebrations of my birth only last about an hour or so.
But Jesus' birth was a very, very special one.
When the Savior was born, a star appeared in the sky.
Far away from Bethlehem in the east, some wise men saw this star. They studied this kind of stuff, so they knew what it meant.
Christ the Savior was born. They followed the star all the way to Bethlehem.
It was a long journey. It probably took a really long time.
Then the star stopped over one house.
And going into the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother, and they fell down and worshipped him.
They gave him amazing, rich presents, gifts fit for a king.
Gold, frankincense, and myrrh.
What a sight that has must been.
Well, the celebration isn't over yet.
God loved us so much that he promised to send us a Savior. Then he kept that promise by sending Jesus.
It was a humble birth, a stable, a manger, shepherds, but wow, think of the angels singing.
Think of the new star shining. Think of those wise men starting to pack, because this birth is definitely worth a road trip.
God gives us the same joy this Christmas.
Christ the Savior is born.
Let's share the good news. Go and tell someone.
And I hope y'all enjoyed it, and we wish you a Merry Christmas. Everybody say Merry Christmas one more time.
Merry Christmas!
And dinner will be in the fellowship hall, and everybody's welcome to stay and eat dinner with us. So we're so glad that you were here tonight. All right, thank y'all.
Okay, well, don't worry, people. I have pretty signed autographs on the back.
I'm gonna untie you. over there. Okay, you got her? Thank you. Y'all did very good. Oh, right here. Just put it right here. Call it right here.
It's still off.
I know. It's okay.